What was the black market at your school? In high school there was this game fad where people would try to stealth zip tie other people's bags to their desks, shoes together, whatever, so they'd be stuck when the bell rang. One guy sold the heavy duty zip ties and another sold mini scissors for easy escape. My high school was really bad about this. Until one day a kid was sleeping on his desk and someone got a zip tie in his gauge and stuck it to the desk bar. Slapped him awake, and when he bolted upright the zip tie ripped his gauge out of his ear. Anybody caught with zip ties after that got immediate suspension. Always wondered what would happen if you took a small padlock and put it in someone's gauge. Would they just be freaked? You could get a locksmith to pick the lock most likely, or at worst get bolt cutters, or you have a stylish earring that you won't have to worry about losing. In elementary school, it was flavored toothpicks. The most popular was soaked in cinnamon oil. First time I tasted Fireball whiskey took me right back to first grade. Oh god, I forgot about this. No idea why this was such a big thing. I'm laughing my ass off. Just imagining you in a bar, half in the bag, getting a shot of Fireball and saying, "Damn, this takes me back to first grade," while all the alcoholics in earshot just nod silently over their beers. LOL. Same. All I can think of when drinking Fireball is middle school hallways. In elementary school my friend had a sticker maker, and we pumped out hundreds of stickers with Neopets on them. Everyone wanted them. We were making away like bandits before teachers started to get pissed they were showing up all over the desk's walls etc. Eventually we got called into the principal's office and had to stop. I miss my Neopets. I would honestly probably still play it now if it had ever truly been redone for the internet of today. They're currently putting their time and energy into making it a NFT metaverse. I wish I was kidding, but the old Neopets is forgotten and dead. Friend of mine had a sticker maker, and made a mint. I went to like 9 different schools, but the one that stands out is Marbles. Marbles were banned at the school, because kids were getting into arguments over them, as well as digging up the gardens making marbles tracks. I was a substitute teacher at a charter school. The kids and the teachers liked me, so they kept bringing me back. I noticed there was a kid who brought a huge duffel bag every class, but he was also in sports, so I didn't really think of it. One day, he shows up with a can of the drink I had every day when he noticed I hadn't brought one. The kid was running a snack business out of his locker and the duffel bag was packed with snacks and soda. Most teachers usually shut it down in their room, but he didn't disrupt the class while I was there and he had the monster flavor I liked. He was the current student selling and had inherited the business from a recently graduated senior. The school had tried to shut him down at least once. The kids noticed I didn't say anything, so they paid more attention in class knowing I'd give them a minute or two at the end to get a snack. My nephew did this. Grandma always bought a lot of snacks for him and his brother when she came to visit, but these two would never ever eat them. Instead, they would just pack up their duffel and go to school, selling it to make money. They didn't need to, they had everything they needed at home. They just enjoyed being merchants. Hope they bought something nice for grandma with it. They bought a copy of Madden 08 to enjoy in her honor. Beating kids up. In grade 8, so 13 years old, there were a few hitmen. Huge bully type kids that would beat up anyone you wanted. Price started at $20. Within a few weeks it was up to $50. The hitmen were all independent, so you could pay one to beat up another. Lasted about 3 months when everyone came to school looking like hell. Fun fact, I missed getting beat up, because the guy hired was too busy, so he kept the money and told me to tell everyone I was beat up. Win-win. I would have paid the bullies to fight each other. Gladiator fights. Fight. Fight for my amusement. You only need to pay one. Fossils. My friend was caught selling fossils to all the other kids. They were all over the playground, she just knew where to find them. Mayo, this is the best one. Did you ever figure out what kind of animals they were? The fossils of ancient students that didn't make it out of the sandbox. And the schoolyard cat buried them in the sand. Even in a Christian all-girls school. Pokemon cards and weed. Surprisingly no tobacco. tampons too. All girls Catholic high school here too. I ran bets on how often the principal said community during her assembly speeches. She once got into the 20s. And we had poker games at lunch with snacks as bets. Sorry if this is a weird question. I'm a boy, but why was there a black market for tampons? Couldn't you all just buy them normally from a shop? If you're anything like my conservative parents, tampons are evil and make you lose your virginity. I'd used to double up pads to make an extra long pad at school since my flow was so heavy, but of course all it takes is the pad folding a bit from sitting in a weird position for a while, and there goes any protection the moment you stand up, especially in school. The day I finally learned to put in a tampon was like the clouds breaking and the heavens shining upon me. At last, the Red Sea could be controlled. And the combination of a heavy ultra tampon and a backup pad led to no leaks even on the days where it feels like a murder scene is coming out of me. Air potatoes. For those unaware, air potatoes are an invasive species of vines that grow to cover massive swathes of forest areas in Florida, and usually result in the death of everything they grow on as they suck the nutrients out of the surrounding flora. There was a gigantic infestation of these vines around my school, and they bore small, roughly golf ball sized potatoes, which were very poisonous if eaten. Perfect size fruits for pelting your enemies on the playground. Obviously, fifth graders being in possession of weaponized poisonous potatoes was frowned upon, so you had to be careful not to get caught picking them. Eventually the whole school was covered in bruises and welts from the Great War of 2003 to 2005. Finally they built a fence around the playground and a ceasefire had to be declared as all remaining ammunition began to rot. We had these growing in our yard when we were kids. I think I was like 8 and I pulled one off the vine and aimed at my dad who was outside playing with me and my siblings. My dad didn't flinch when I aimed, because I was incredibly unathletic. I hurled the potato at him and hit him square in the forehead. My siblings and I all just stood there shocked and I naturally ran to hide. No idea why I hid. I honestly think my dad would have probably congratulated me on the good throw. Soft drinks became black market in my final year, as the health department had passed guidelines about selling them in schools. One of the teachers initially was selling them from his office, but got shut down pretty quickly. So I decided to take it up. I'd get up early and drive past the supermarket on the way in, and grab a 30 pack of Coke, Fanta, Sprite, etc. Then I'd sell them from my car at lunch breaks. That got shut down too. So I shift my approach, ended up coming in early to school and dropping the cans off at various empty lockers around the school and padlocking them shut. Then at lunch I'd walk around with a bunch in my pockets and sell them, stocking up at the drop points as I continued my walk. Didn't really try to make money off it, was a bit more of a frick you to the man. I keep seeing posts about banned soft drinks and my high school has energy drinks available to students. I know how awful it was when health guidelines got hold of schools. I was in the generation where Jamie Oliver ruined our school dinners. For the 6 months where my school still sold chips, but stopped putting salt shakers on the tables, I made some money buying boxes of little salt sachets and selling them in the chips dinner room. Marbles, and then we would play marbles, but for keeps. It was basically a whole currency, because you could sell those marbles to other kids and based on the design you would know how much it was worth. Oh yeah, my elementary school had a huge marble thing going for a while there. We'd all come to school with our marble bags in our backpacks and have intense games during recess. Eventually almost everybody was playing with steelies, because the glass ones would get chipped or shattered. Fun times. A chip was like a battle scar at my school. Marbles with chips on them were like trophies and had an even higher trade value. So silly looking back, but it was all good fun. We did this too. And if you had no decent marbles you could then offer up your lunch, stationery or even your shoes. A lot of angry parents when shoes started being traded for small blobs of glass. Mid-2000s had a kid who kept finding ways around the web blockers and he would pass the info around so we could surf the web unimpeded for a couple days. School would find out, update the web blocker and the kid would find another way around. Lasted the whole year. When I was in high school in 2008-ish, we all had these shooty dull laptops. Some kid figured out how to install COD 1 and host servers on the school network. Shoot spread like wildfire, and I would say for a few weeks a large majority of my high school was playing COD in the middle of class most of the day. Eventually the school caught on and starting suspending kids for it, so we all bailed, but it was hilarious while it lasted. That's awesome. I missed it by a couple years. We just had the desktop computers. After I graduated, the library got laptops for classes to use. I'm sure the kid at my school would have figured out something like that. At least you got to enjoy it for a little while. I am a teacher. We had two spawned by Ovid. The first was toward the beginning of the outbreak. The school had a policy that if you have two symptoms of Ovid, you go home. So if a kid had a headache and wants Tylenol, that's one. But we live in an area with really bad allergies and almost everyone has runny nose, sore throat in the fall. So that's two. Teachers pretty quickly turned a blind eye to bottles of ibuprofen being passed around by students to avoid going home. When we had a mask mandate, the office got tired of giving out masks to kids who broke forgot them. So they started charging $5 to parents' accounts per mask. Fairly rich private school, so this wouldn't cause a hardship for anyone. A kid's parents got annoyed about spending $5 a day, so they sent him to school with a box of masks to put in his backpack. One of his classmates forgot her mask and I told her, well, you can go to the office in GT1 $4.05 or, student, might sell you one $4.03. And so the black market for masks was born. I heard later that a different teacher sent him to the office for it. So I checked in with my boss to make sure he didn't get in trouble. My boss laughed and said it was brilliant. Then told me at his previous school there was a kid who rented out belts and ties to kids who forgot them to avoid dress code violations. Did you end up getting a suit?